Welcome back to this video. We are going to continue building on our plugin and building our widgets from this very setup. And I hope that you learned something from our action hooks and filters video that was previously shared. We are now going to get this particular class, which I am now going to call widgets, TechiePress Elementor widgets, because we want to build a number of them. And even here, I'll correct this so that we have the right class. And this class is using this method of getInstance. Now this getInstance method is just getting a unique version. It's just getting this particular class and calling it once. The only issue we have is that we have not returned the self-instance right here of this particular class. And I'm going to go into this sample page. It's the one that we're going to use to edit in Elementor. Of course, it opens up with Gutenberg, but I'm going to click Edit with Elementor, and that will allow us to go into Elementor itself. Now, you'll see that we have a number of widgets that are here, like in the basic, we have the pro versions, and these are not active. I cannot actually drag them because I don't have the pro. And you'll see that one of these menus that I would really like to use in my page as the nav menu are actually not available for me to use. So I'm going to build my own custom nav menu from this onset. So that will allow us to drag and drop that widget, let's say from our panel right here, and drop it in here. So let me go back to the code, and this is what we're going to do. So for now, we're going to ignore these rules that we are supposed to work with and try to just build something basic, and then you'll see how eventually we get to build our plugin and make it a little bit bigger and do a couple of things. So the first thing that I'm going to do is that I'm going to come here in our plugin, and I'm going to create a folder which I'm going to call widgets for now, okay? And inside this widgets, we're going to create a new widget file, which is going to be a PHP file, and we're going to call it the nav-menu.php. That will be our file that will store our widget for our menu. So in here, we have the widget code for the Elementor nav menu. So I'll even say Elementor or custom Elementor nav menu. I'll save this. That's just a comment to tell us what the file is about. And inside that file, we're going to have a new class, which we're going to call nav menu. And what it will do is that it's going to extend the widget base class. And this widget base class actually comes from Elementor, and it will give us a number of things that we're going to see and use inside this very file that we are working. And you'll see that on line 3, my editor has actually added the namespace for me automatically. So the first thing that we are going to do inside this class is that we're going to have a public function, and the function which is going to be getName. And you will see from my editor that's telling me that inside the Elementor controls stack, there's something called getName. It's an abstracted method that we are using here. So we're going to add that right here, and then I'll add, of course, my brackets. And in here, we're just going to return and say the name of our particular widget, and we shall call it custom menu. Or to make things a little bit nicer, we shall say TechiePress, shall call it TechiePress menu. That's the first thing we need to do. We are naming our particular widget. Now, as we extend this widget class, you will see that my editor has already pulled in this class for me. It had said we need to use the Elementor widget base, which is basically saying we need to go into this namespace of Elementor, and we're going to get this class called widget base. So this is a modern way of working with PHP. It's called using namespaces, and I have made a video about this. If you want to see what namespaces are, you can check out the video that is in the description right below, and you'll be able to understand how namespaces work. In fact, we can also add our own namespace right here in our plugin so that we don't have things that are conflicting. So I'm going to add a namespace and I'm going to say TechiePress, and I'll say we are going to be making TechiePress Elementor widgets. So that will be our own namespace in case we want to use this particular file in any other place. So let's go back to creating the nav menu. So we have now a name for our widget. The next thing that we need to do is we need to get a title. So we get a title and say public function, and we're going to say get underscore title. And inside that, we're going to say we need to return. And here I'll just get the same thing and say, let's get the TechiePress menu, paste it there. We can actually use internationalization at this point because we want people to, maybe we want to change TechiePress menu into a different language, and we want to see people in France having this in French, we want to see people in Italy have this in Italian. We can do this, and then we can namespace it with our particular text domain that we already announced here in our first file. So I'm going to copy that and I'm going to paste it here, and you'll see that I actually made a mistake here when I was returning the get name. This is supposed to be more of an ID, so I'm just going to put everything in lowercase and put a dash and correct that so that we don't have this breaking. Now the next thing that we need to do after getting the title, because this title is what will be shown when we come here, you'll be seeing that name there. The next thing we need to do is, if you look at this widget, is that we have things like icons right here. Now I'll come back in here and I'm going to say public function, and I'll say get icon, which is a method coming from Elementor as well, from the widget base. You'll see that that's available for us to use. Now Elementor has a number of libraries inside it. For example, we can use Font Awesome. We can use things like the icon library, and that will allow us to have icons that are linear in nature, that are just more like line art, like this. Or we can actually use something like Font Awesome. So in here we're going to return, and you can return something like FA menu, and that will allow you to use Font Awesome and use a Font Awesome menu. So I'm going to comment this out, and we shall see in the near future, once we are done, we'll be able to compare the two and see which one looks better. So in here I'm going to use something like icon nav dash menu, and that will give us something that is similar to what we have here in the pro version of the nav menu. And I am picking that from Elementor itself. Now after adding our icon, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to go and make a public function. And inside there we're going to use the get categories, which is a function also coming from this widget base class. And we are going to add the name of the category that we want. So in here we return, of course. And here when we are returning, we return an array. And inside this array, we have a number of options. We have something like basic, we have things like general, and that is coming all from Elementor. We have basic, we have the pro, we have the general, we have things like site, WooCommerce, and WordPress. So for now, I'm going to choose the basic because I want it to appear right here. So I'll choose the basic. We can later on just check this out to see what it will look like in the general, or in all the other sections of categories that we do have. And we can actually be able to make our own category, like you'll see all these other six options we have here. Let's say we have a bunch of widgets. We can make our own TechiePress category right here, and then we'll be able to add our each widget right there. And I'll be able to show you that. So let me leave here a little to-do comment and say to-do, add our own category in Elementor. So for now we leave it in the basic, and then the next thing we are going to do is we need to go and tap into the next method. So say public function underscore register, control. It will allow us to register the controls of the particular widget. For example, if I go back in here and drag and drop this right here, you'll see that we have these particular things like content width, box, columns, gaps, height, and so on. So these are controls that we can add to our particular widget. And we're going to leave that method there so that when we have our own widget, we'll be able to add a number of controls in there. And then finally, I'm going to just use a protected method here and say we're going to have a function. And we're going to say we're going to call this the render method. And that render method will allow us to output the widget on the front end. So that's what this method is for. And then similarly, if we have this on the front end, we're going to have another method which is actually called the content underscore content template. This particular method allows us to render the widget on the back end inside our Elementor right here. So for example, when you drag and drop this image, you'll see that this is being rendered right here, and that is because of the content template method that is passed on inside this widget base class. Now that we have all these things put together, what is needed right here? I'm just going to make sure that we have this file being called inside our main file. So I'm going to come back here to the initWidgets class, and there are two things that I need to do. One is I need to require widget class that we've created. Then I need to register the widget with Elementor. So those are the two tasks that we need to do inside this particular file, and then we shall pass this method inside our init plugins inside the widget classes. We can do all of this inside one function, but it would become gigantic. So that's why we actually just get this little method and we break out so that we can separate concerns. So at the end of the day, I will say this class, let me pass in this method right here, and that will allow me to do the different things that we have here and then pass them to this method. So the last thing that I'll do is that I'm now going to add our own namespace in this file because we already had this namespace here starting for our plugin. I'm going to add the namespace right here as well. So I'll add this TechiePress Elementor widgets. And then inside that, I'm going to use the PSR4 convention, and I'm going to say we are going to go into the file called widgets, and inside widgets is where we're going to find this nav menu class. So I'll save that, and then I'm going to just copy this. I'll clean this a bit, and then I'll come back here into my space, and then I'll say we need to use, and what we want to use is this namespace of TechiePress Elementor widgets, widgets, and we're going to be looking for the nav menu class. So I'll save that, and then you're going to see that when we come down to our init widgets right here, we're actually going to use that particular method. First things first is now I'm going to require the widget class, and I'm going to say let's require once, which is a PHP function. And then what we're going to do is we're going to say, let's get this directory that we are in, and we are going to add quotations and a slash since we're in the root folder. We're going to go inside the widgets folder, and inside the widgets folder, we're going to get the nav-menu.php file. So once we've required that file, I'm going to save this. Let me come back and reload, just to make sure we've not broken anything. And you'll see it's telling us uncode class, we have Elementor widget base not found in our file. So one of the things that we need to do is just go a little bit ahead and we'll be able to clear this. So I'll come back here and I'm going to go to register the widget with Elementor. Now, the first thing that I need to do is I need to go to the root, and I'm going to find the Elementor class, and then inside that I'm going to look for the plugin class, and inside that we're going to get an instance. We shall use the instance method on the Elementor plugin, and inside that we're going to say let us get the widgets manager, which is a function, which is a method, and we shall chain on and say let us also get the register widget type. And inside the register widget type we're going to create a new instance of our nav menu class. And once we do that and hit the semicolon right here, we shall have registered this widget with Elementor. So let's go back to our front end, I'll reload this. And this issue actually comes in from a very simple hook that we've not added in. So inside my construct method right here, I'm going to come here and add an action. And inside this, we're going to need to add a hook, which is Elementor slash widgets slash widgets registered. That's the hook we need to have, and we're going to pass in that very method. I'll copy this, paste it here, and the method we need to have is init widgets. And that means we just need to remove this line right here because we are calling that particular class right here. So I'll save this, and then I'll come back here and I'll reload, and you'll see we have line 33. We need to close this with a semicolon. We'll save, go back to our web page and reload. We'll reload here and you'll see that now our widget is actually coming out, and you'll see that we have our TechiePress menu showing up right here. We can drag and drop in the instance here. It has nothing to it, nothing in the advanced, but we have our widget and it's showing up. So that's what's really important right now. And now that we have our widget showing up here, I'm going to just click update, and then I'll try to preview this, and you'll see that we have nothing showing up here because we don't have anything rendered out at all. So I'll come back to my editor right here. I'm going to go back into our nav menu, and then I'm going to go inside the render here, and I'm going to escape the PHP and open up PHP again. I'll copy this as well and just paste it here, and we're just going to have something very simple, which is a div, and that div will say hello widget, hello widget. Copy the same thing, paste it here, tab it in to just look nice, and then I'll come back and reload this as well as reload this. And you see we have our hello widget here, not editable in any case, but also we have our hello widget on the front end. So I'll come back in here and start doing stuff that is really necessary. But before we go to do that, I just want to clear out some of the things that we talked about earlier. For example, when we talked about the categories, right now, when we go back to the widget section, you'll see that we have our widget showing up right here. But if I change that to the general, hit save, I'll reload this page, I'll scroll down to the general section, and you're going to see that we have it here, and we can actually drag and drop it here. So you can add it to any of these sections, and we can have our widget stored in any of these categories by going to our code and changing get categories option through the different IDs that have been given to us. It's like we can say pro-elements, we can use the WooCommerce elements, or general, or basic, and you can be able to do that. And by using any of these right here, let's say you change this to Pro Elements and paste it here and save, you should be able to get it inside the Pro Elements category. So I'll reload this just for us to see what's happening. And when you go into the Pro Category section, you'll see that we have our widget right there. We can try it in the WordPress section, save this, come back and reload. We'll scroll down to the WordPress section, and then we shall scroll down and you'll see that we have it right here and we can drag and drop it. So you can add your widget to any of the categories that are available, and rather you could even make your own, and that's what we're going to do in the next video. If you found this video very helpful, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, or even share it with your friends. I'll be continuing this series to make sure that we can complete it, and this is going to take us maybe the next few weeks, so I'll be releasing one Elementor video every week so that we can complete this series. Otherwise, thank you for watching and enjoy whatever you're developing.